It's now been 4 days since a Grand Rapids teen went missing, and her family is concerned that she may be in a dangerous situation with someone that she met on the internet. There have been tips, sightings, and several leads on the whereabouts of Zoe Stehauer, but she still isn't home. 24-Hour News 8's Mark Thompson has the story tonight from a family pleading for her safe return.
We're not mad. We love you. Just come home.
A tearful plea from mom, her daughter, 16-year-old Zoe Stehauer, gone since Wednesday night. Mom says she ran away from her grandmother's house here at the Ironwood condo complex off Leonard on Grand Rapids Northwest Side. She says Zoe stole some money, a couple hundred dollars worth, and took off. Now they fear she may be in danger.
I'm just worried about her safety, and I just want her to come back home. She met somebody online. I don't know if that's who she's with. Nobody has seen her since Thursday, and I just want her safely returned to me.
Grand Rapids Police is investigating, following up on sightings and leads, one tip leading them to a house in this neighborhood off Hogan and Clyde Park. Mom and Dad met investigators there last night.
She was possibly at a girlfriend's house, and they allowed her to leave on her own and didn't compel her to come home.
Rumors on social media are circulating that Zoe doesn't want to be found and wants to be left alone, but she's just a minor. And while mom has some idea of who she may be with, his online profiles are shady, she says, which only adds to the confusion and fear.
She has met this man online that we're finding may not even be a real man. We're very concerned. She's 16 years old. He's 23 years old. There was some pictures and some things that really made us concerned for her well-being and what it is she's doing and what he wants with her.
In Grand Rapids, Mark Thompson, 24-Hour News 8.
Obviously a lot of concern there. Stehauer is about 5'4", 140 pounds. She's black hair, green eyes, and a 9-inch scar that runs down the back of her head to her neck. If you know where she might be or anything that might help this family, you are asked to call the police directly or silent observer if you want to stay anonymous.